Hey guys! Hoje a gente vai começar a unidade 6. A gente vai começar a falar sobre o weather phenomena, os fenômenos climáticos. Nice, isn't it? Um vocabulário bem legal. Follow me. Take a look at this picture. Let's check. Before traveling, it's always nice to analyze the weather. Avoid the blizzard, the climate change, cloud weather and drought spots. O que quer dizer isso? Antes de viajar, é sempre legal analisar o tempo, o clima, né? Esse weather é o clima. Evitar, avoid, a nevasca, the blizzard, the climate change, a mudança climática, cloudy weather, sabe aquele tempo todo nublado, se de repente a gente quiser pegar um solzinho? And drought, e drought spots, ou seja, lugares que tem muita seca, né? No Nordeste a gente tem lugares assim. É para isso que serve a previsão do tempo, que nem sempre funciona, né, gente? Vamos combinar. It's always nice to check, é sempre legal checar. Moving on. When going outdoors, note floods, hurricanes, lightning, precipitations. Quando a gente sai de casa, esse outdoors é quando a gente sai de casa. Sempre é legal notar quando tem, quando vai chover, precipitation é quando começa a chover, né? No caso, no verão, tem muita chuva e muita enchente, né? Floods, hurricanes, lightning and precipitations. Ou seja, a gente fica atento a furacões, raios. E precipitations, como eu já falei, essa chuva que começa, né? Essa precipitação de água que a gente tem que sempre notar, né? Aqui no Brasil, eu acho que o maior problema são as enchentes, né? A gente não vê muitos raios ou vê. O que vocês acham? Vamos ver, ó. Weather prediction aims to avoid thunderstorms and tornadoes. Ou seja, a previsão do tempo, ela não só está preocupada em nos ajudar a decidir para onde ir, quando ir, para onde viajar, mas sim para evitar alguns tipos de raio ou chuvas de raio, chuvas de trovões, tornados, para tentar nos proteger o máximo possível. Bem, eu citei alguns tipos, né, de questões climáticas, mas existem várias. E é legal sempre saber o que está acontecendo ao nosso redor. Vamos assistir um vídeo para conferir e você me conta o que você mais gostou?
Human activities, from pollution to overpopulation, are driving up the Earth's temperature and fundamentally changing the world around us. The main cause is a phenomenon known as the greenhouse effect. Gases in the atmosphere, such as water vapor, carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, and chlorofluorocarbons, let the sun's light in, but keep some of the heat from escaping, like the glass walls of a greenhouse. The more greenhouse gases in the atmosphere, the more heat gets trapped, strengthening the greenhouse effect and increasing the Earth's temperature. Human activities, like the burning of fossil fuels, have increased the amount of CO2 in the atmosphere by more than a third since the Industrial Revolution. The rapid increase in greenhouse gases in the atmosphere has warmed the planet at an alarming rate. While Earth's climate has fluctuated in the past, atmospheric carbon dioxide hasn't reached today's levels in hundreds of thousands of years. Climate change has consequences for our oceans, our weather, our food sources, and our health. Ice sheets, such as Greenland and Antarctica, are melting. The extra water that was once held in glaciers causes sea levels to rise and spills out of the oceans, flooding coastal regions. Warmer temperatures also make weather more extreme. This means not only more intense major storms, floods, and heavy snowfall, but also longer and more frequent droughts. These changes in weather pose challenges. Growing crops becomes more difficult. The areas where plants and animals can live shift, and water supplies are diminished. In addition to creating new agricultural challenges, climate change can directly affect people's physical health. In urban areas, the warmer atmosphere creates an environment that traps and increases the amount of smog. This is because smog contains ozone particles, which increase rapidly at higher temperatures. Exposure to higher levels of smog can cause health problems such as asthma, heart disease, and lung cancer. While the rapid rate of climate change is caused by humans, humans are also the ones who can combat it. If we work to replace fossil fuels with renewable energy sources like solar and wind, which don't produce greenhouse gas emissions, we might still be able to prevent some of the worst effects of climate change. Human activities, from pollution to overpopulation.